Hey, what is up, you guys? This is Main Stage News. Today, I want to start out by talking about the Xbox One and the good things about it, the pros of the Xbox One. Now, during the reveal, I saw one thing that I thought was kind of cool, and that was the fact that you could watch TV on it. Now, first of all, I kind of want to know if this is like incorporated with the subscription fee that you have with Xbox, or if you're gonna have to pay like another fee to be able to watch TV, or if you're gonna like have to connect something else to your Xbox to be able to watch TV. The way it seems, it's just the TV is like streamed over the internet to you, and it probably is gonna be incorporated in the fee for your subscription on Xbox. Now, really, that's an honestly really cool thing, because everybody usually pays at least like probably $60 or up to get TV to their TVs, obviously, all the TVs in their house. Now, if you have really only one TV, like say you only have a TV in your living room and the rest of your house, you don't really have any other TVs, this is actually a really cool thing, because if you don't have to pay an extra fee or anything to be able to get TV, you're going to be able to have television without actually having to pay for television, if that makes any sense, because you can watch TV on the internet now, but nobody really does that because they'd rather be chilling on their couch and not be like on their PC watching TV on their monitor or up in their room or whatever. Now you can have your Xbox down in your living room or whatever connected to your TV and have your whole family watching television. Now, one thing that I thought was just kind of gimmicky, and I would have thought that Xbox would have finally figured out that we really don't think it's that cool of a thing, and it honestly, it is kind of cool the way they showed it to us. The Kinect incorporated with the Xbox and everything, how they include a Kinect with your Xbox now. I mean, that is kind of cool, and some of the things that you can do with it is cool, but it's not something that gets me excited for next-gen consoles. It's more of a gimmicky thing to be like, oh yeah, we got this cool little thing that you can swipe your hand and be all crazy with, and it'll do this and it'll do that. I mean, like, whatever, it's neat, it's cool, but I honestly don't think it's something that is as great as they made it out to be, because first, I kind of want to see what it actually can do. I want to put it in my living room just to see if it's, like, capable of consistently doing the things that they were doing during the conference. And if it is, it'll be kind of cool. But again, like I said, I just never really thought the Kinect was like that innovative or really cool at all. I mean, it's neat, but it's not really something that would like persuade me to buy this console over this console. Now, the thing that I want to move on to that I thought was just honestly kind of stupid. The entire conference was about the Kinect and the TV. Where are the games? Show me some of the things that it can do with games. Is there anything like really innovative with games? I mean, they have a thing where you can like have your tablet be as like a little second. I mean, that's kind of cool. That's neat. But where are the games? I mean, that's again another like gimmicky thing. I mean, in certain situations, I could see how that would be useful. Say like I'm playing a game like Skyrim and RPG. I could like have the map up on my tablet or whatever, and be able to. I mean, we already have that anyways. But I'm just saying, I could like have my map up on for a game like Skyrim and be able to look at where I'm at while I'm actually playing the game. I mean, that's neat. It's whatever. But besides that, what can they do with games? I realize they have the little thing where you can use a projector and show things throughout your room to make you more immersed into your game. For those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, you can like connect your Xbox to a projector and it can like show things around your TV. Like, say, like, weather effects on the side of your TV, just to get you more immersed in the game. But let's be honest here. How many people are actually going to do that? That's a really niche group of people. How many people play on a projector? How many people are going to be willing to use their projector, put it in the same room as their TV, just to be able to utilize this? I mean, I'm sure there's some people that are going to do it. I don't think it's that different. It's kind of cool if I had it. If I had money to spare, I might buy a projector and a TV just for kicks and giggles, just to see how it is and everything. But, like, where are the games? What are they doing with games? And one thing that pisses me off is the fact that you're going to have a subscription, a code, to be able to play your games now. Why that makes me mad is because I have multiple accounts on Xbox. I let my little sister play my Xbox. She has a different account because I have like this family plan thing where I can have like 4 users and pay only like $100 for a year. I mean, that's cheap, but now, before I could use my game on anything that I wanted, And are you still going to be able to do that? Are you going to have to buy a code to be able to play the games? Because the way it seems is, if you want to have your friend borrow it, or in like my situation, have my little sister be able to play it on our other Xbox, or my other Xbox, she has to have like a code to be able to play on her account. I don't even know what to say right now. And you know one term that really makes me mad? The term next generation graphics, next generation, you know, games. We have that right now on PC. We can play, quote, next generation on our PC. We already have that. It's not that different. It's not that cool. It's not that innovative. And I don't want to talk about Call of Duty Ghosts too much right now. But one thing I want to say is they kept saying next generation engine, next generation graphics. But all these little things that they were showing, I mean, I can already play that on games like Crysis. I can already play that on all these games that are already out. And it just because, oh my god, I don't even, I'm just a little upset. It's not that cool. It's not that innovative. And I use my console for gaming. I realize there's a bunch of people that really do use their consoles for Netflix and that type of thing. But what about the people that only really use their consoles for gaming? They didn't show anything for us. They barely showed anything that's innovative and cool enough for me to be like, dude, I actually need to buy a console now. My PC, it can play games at insanely good resolutions and insanely good and quote next gen graphics. But this Xbox can do this, and I honestly think that's cool enough to dish out $400 or $500 to buy one. Or for the case of PlayStation 2, because I don't know what they really said that was like that cool or innovative. I don't know. I guess I'm just going on too much of a rant right now. I had a lot higher hopes for this, for the consoles, the next gen consoles. But looks like pretty much I'm going to be sticking to PC gaming. Because there's essentially nothing in the gaming aspect of the next gen consoles that is gonna wanna make me buy a console. Dish out even more money than I already have to be able to buy a console. To be able to buy all of these accessories. Possibly to be able to buy like two or three codes for my other account, a code for my sister's account and not be able to let my friends borrow the games, which I realize you can't let people borrow games on PC. But I don't know, it's just kind of frustrating. But on PC, for like a single player game, like for instance Skyrim, I got that for free on PC, and the only reason why I did that is because I already bought it for Xbox, and I wasn't gonna pay twice for that game. It's a good game, but it's an older game. Now I'm not gonna buy the game twice. And that's the thing with PC, if like you have a single player game that you really want to play, if you really want to, if you want to take the chance, you can get that game and not have to pay for it. I'm not going to go into further detail. You guys can use your imagination. You guys are smart. But I think I'm pretty much done with my little talk about the next-gen Xbox, Xbox One. Xbox One. Whatever. If you guys liked the video, God forsake if somebody actually liked this video, definitely hit that like button. If you have something to say, drop your comment below. Tell me your feelings on the next-gen consoles. And also, if you haven't done so already, and you agree with my opinions, please subscribe, and I will without a doubt talk to you guys later. Thank you. Bye.